If you know anything about the ministry that the Lord's given me, you probably, if you've heard anything, you go, man, that guy just talks about sin, he nails people, he's the meanest preacher that ever walked the planet. But let me tell you something. When it comes to unbelievers who are professing faith in Christ and they're asleep in their sin and they're going to die and go to hell, yes, I am going to rip, because it doesn't appear to me that hardly anyone else is doing that. I am not going to let them go to hell except over my cries that they wake up and see their destruction. But when I pastor, sometimes people come to church if I'm preaching and they go, are you the same guy on YouTube? Because all you do is talk about love. Why? Here's the reason. If the person truly becomes converted, I don't have to do anything. They're sheep. They're going to follow him. As a shepherd, you know what my greatest worry is for the people who are truly converted? I don't want them coming under false condemnation. And I don't want them doubting the love of God. You see, the whole deal depends on conversion. Do you see that? You get them converted, and you talk to them about the unconditional love of God, you know what they'll do? I'll tell you what they won't do. They won't stand there and go, well, if it's like this, let's just sin. No, you tell a true sheep about the unconditional love of God and that it doesn't matter what they do or how far they fail, Christ loves them and is going to restore them and work in them, and a bruised reed He will not break and a smoldering wick He will not put out. You tell them that, they say, well, if it be like that, then I want to love Him more. I want to serve Him more. I want to follow Him. If I'm really free, you see? So all you have to do is get converted and I'll be nice to you. If you know anything about the ministry that the Lord's given me, you probably, if you've heard anything, you go, man, that guy just talks about sin, he nails people, he's the meanest preacher that ever walked the planet. Well, let me tell you something. When it comes to unbelievers who are professing faith in Christ and they're asleep in their sin and they're going to die and go to hell, yes, I am going to rip, because it doesn't appear to me that hardly anyone else is doing that. I am not going to let them go to hell except over my cries that they wake up and see their destruction. But when I pastor, sometimes people come to church if I'm preaching and they go, are you the same guy on YouTube? Because all you do is talk about love. Why? Here's the reason. If the person truly becomes converted, I don't have to do anything. They're sheep. They're going to follow Him. As a shepherd, you know what my greatest worry is for the people who are truly converted? I don't want them coming under false condemnation. And I don't want them doubting the love of God. You see, the whole deal depends on conversion. Do you see that? You get them converted, and you talk to them about the unconditional love of God, you know what they'll do? I'll tell you what they won't do. They won't stand there and go, well, if it's like this, let's just sin. No, you tell a true sheep about the unconditional love of God and that it doesn't matter what they do or how far they fail, Christ loves them and is going to restore them and work in them, and a bruised reed He will not break and a smoldering wick He will not put out. You tell them that, they say, well, if it be like that, then I want to love Him more. I want to serve Him more. I want to follow Him. If I'm really free, you see? So all you have to do is get converted and I'll be nice to you. If you know anything about the ministry that the Lord's given me, you probably... probably, if you've heard anything, you go, man, that guy just talks about sin, sin. He nails people. He's the meanest preacher that ever walked the planet. But let me tell you something. When it comes to unbelievers who are professing faith in Christ and they're asleep in their sin and they're going to die and go to hell, yes, I am going to rip, 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 because it doesn't appear to me that hardly anyone else is doing that. I am not going to let them go to hell except over my cries that they wake up and see their destruction. But when I pastor, sometimes people come to church if I'm preaching and they go, are you the same guy on YouTube? Because all you do is talk about love, 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 love. Why? Here's the reason. If the person truly becomes converted, I don't have to do anything. They're sheep. They're going to follow him. As a shepherd, you know what my greatest worry is for the people who are truly converted? I don't want them coming under false condemnation. And I don't want them doubting the love of God. You see, the whole deal depends on conversion. Do you see that? You get them converted, and you talk to them about the unconditional love of God, you know what they'll do? I'll tell you what they won't do. They won't stand there and go, well, if it's like this, let's just sin. No, you tell a true sheep about the unconditional love of God and that it doesn't matter what they do or how far they fail, Christ loves them and is going to restore them and work in them, and a bruised reed He will not break and a smoldering wick He will not put out. You tell them that, they say, well, if it be like that, then I want to love Him more. I want to serve Him more. I want to follow Him. If I'm really free, you see? So all you have to do is get converted and I'll be nice to you.